Good morning, allies. All right, I'm almost completely off of my cold. Both of my nostrils are flowing air. I'm very excited about that. And one of the main reasons I'm excited about that is I have a meet and greet, I guess you can call it, with some manager types today from different programs. Just me and a couple other people getting to know each other, introductions. And yeah, you can read between the lines on what that could mean. And yeah, so I'm pretty excited. Gonna go talk about myself for an hour, which is always fun. People are wired a certain way. And one of those wirings is the type of people who like to talk about themselves and mention that things they've done, achievements, etc., whatever. I put myself in the, yeah, every once in a while it's fun to talk about yourself, but I am not good enough at it that I do my due diligence and lay down exactly what it is I'm gonna talk up. So that's probably the detriment, right? The best thing you could do is, if you're gonna talk about yourself, then have a canned, you know, bulleted list of things that you wanna talk about that sell you for whatever it is you want someone to purchase you for, right? Something to think about.
There'd be like 20 kids, right? The first kid get up there, and the guy pitch him like $3
Mini rant time. You know, I've talked about multiple times how as we become more civil and gentrified in our societies, we lose skills. Like, most people don't know how to grow anything. Hell, a lot of people don't even know how to cook anymore. We've like compartmentalized that out. We focus on, I don't want to call it a trade, but a skill set, and that's what we dive into completely. And we get emotionally connected to these things that fill our brains in with those feelings that we used to have if we would have to actually go out there and pluck a turkey after it's dead, or gut a deer, or whatever, till the earth. Now we just watch UFC and we watch people beat the shit out of each other. Or we watch football, right? That replaces that visceral doing that the human being psyche needs. Well, so case in point, right? We were so attached emotionally to these concepts and these ideas and these symbols. Warren Beatty screwed up the Oscars, the Academy Awards, naming La La Land instead of whatever the other one was. I didn't watch it, okay? I just know of it, and I read the news story about it because of this topic. So it turns out Price Waterhouse is the company that runs the Academy Awards. They handle the distribution of the envelopes. It's an accounting company. Why? Because a bunch of drunk movie stars, probably not the best at making sure the appropriate people are being selected, picked, and the right movies are placed. Well, Warren Beatty screwed it up and ended up going to the other movie. After that happened, though, the two individuals, or the one individual from Price Waterhouse, they had to have bodyguards assigned to them because of a serious amount of death threats that were phoned in against that individual. Now, see, here's my take on this. So you're so wrapped up in the concept of a bunch of movie stars getting an award for a movie they're in. Not even the entertainment, right? The award for the creation of the entertainment, that you're willing to call in a death threat against an accountant who screwed up his job. I believe he'd been working with the Academy Awards for like 10, 20 years, something like that. So no slouch, he just made a mistake, and we're gonna kill him. We're gonna threaten his life. That is how screwed up our priorities are and how messed up the things we hold value, like actually emotional sway on our lives. I couldn't give a damn, and people are threatening to kill over it. Wow. That thing is wrapped in carbon fiber. What the radio?
That was Dan Ring.
All right, guys, I'm going in. We've got two hot leads on vending locations. I'm gonna go hit up both of them. I'm gonna hit up the most foot traffic one, or what Leia believes the most foot traffic one, first. She says the place is always busy. You should put the machine there. So I'm going to do that. The reason is I don't have enough mic and ikes, and that's not because I hate them all. It's because I grossly misunderstood how much the hoppers hold. The hoppers hold a lot of candy. I'll dump the whole bag into one hopper, and I think it'll still like put more than another bag into it to fill it all the way up, which is fine, no big deal. I'm just gonna fill up what I got, place it, and I'm gonna go get more candy, get the second machine, see if I can place that one probably tomorrow or something. Okay, right behind me, Kebab Crush. Let's hope for the best. Okay, kebab place was a no-go. The partner, and we made a note of this, it sounded like the person we talked to had not spoke to the partner yet, so that's probably why there was some confusion. She said that she would speak to her partner and get back to us, or I can call back next week. So, not a no, still positive, and that's kind of just what you have to go on, so keep pushing it. Next stop is a poke place. Okay, so that didn't go great either. It sounds like the person that Leia talked to was a manager, which is fine, but not necessarily the owner. Owner didn't know about it, and he's gotta think about it. That is what happens. I think you just have to remain positive and keep doing small things every day, or at least planning to do things every day to get the machines placed. So we'll just keep at it. So respect to the guys who go out there every day and hustle it and code call and pound pavement and do all that stuff, because it's hard, man. It's hard work getting out there and trying to, of course. Look at this guy. Jackass. Man. He like sped up to cut somebody off and then light turned red and he just kept blowing through the red light to turn right, and then I had to slow down the whole thing because I'm already in the intersection. Real good guy, that guy. But redeeming quality. When I pulled up next to him, he gave me the wave, the sorry, blah, blah, blah. So no harm, no foul. Everything's good again. The karmic balance has been restored. That's a burr right there. So there's this concept of business that I learned from Leia. It's called a 10% entrepreneur. And what that means is 10% of your time goes into whatever it is, some entrepreneurial practice. So you got a job like me. I have a good job. I have a great job. I've got good benefits. I make good money. I could blow my free time sitting in front of my TV or in front of a video game system or in front of my computer or whatever and make no extra money. Me, I make YouTube videos, which regardless of how much fun I do at it, it does make money. It's still a hobby. I wouldn't call it an entrepreneurial pursuit right now because I'm not really trying to make it much better than it is. Incrementally I do, but not. I'm not trying to run it like a business. It's still running it like a hobby. However, this vending gig, I'm running it like a business. I'm keeping track of all the money, the expenditures, where we're at, and trying to, you know, always stay ahead of the losses. Of course, we're not there yet. We're still underwater, but it's less than 10% of my time, and that is kind of the 10% entrepreneurial mindset. It's that you've got a good, your main hustle in which you're sustaining, you're staying above water. And then you work these side hustles, these 10% entrepreneurial things where you treat it like a real business opportunity. And it teaches you or shows you whether that's something you want to step up to scale to become your new main gig or not, or it just always stays your 10% gig. It's an interesting concept. Wow. Sweet, sassy molassie. Oh, sweet Jesus. This is a beer made by Ballast Point. It's called the Indra Kunindra, a limited release India style export stout. I just read that and I bought it. Did not read the ingredients. Stout with Madras curry, cumin, cayenne, coconut, and kefir lime. Yo! You know how I said you could curry a boot and I'd eat it? I'm still gonna drink this, but this is crazy. Okay. You know how this is gonna sound maybe culturally insensitive, and I apologize for that. Do you you know how some Indian people have a smell of curry, kind of a pervasive curry slash cumin smell? And that's totally a generalization. I appreciate that. You smell this, and that's what it's, the cumin smell. You can smell it. That doesn't mean BO. I don't mean it like that. I mean a pervasive smell. Neither good nor bad, because I love curry and I love cumin. I am going to save the rest of this for Leia, or she will kill me. I feel like I really owe it to you guys to explain this. This is wild, wild stuff, this beer. It reminds me of an actually spicy, like, curried goat. And it's not so much gamey, like, it doesn't taste like meat. Well, no, there is a gaminess to this. This is amazing. And you're gonna be hearing me going like, I don't wanna drink no gamey ass beer. Guys, this is insane. Dude, I think I'm gonna run by Granada. I'm gonna buy another one of these and I'm gonna give it to Darren because I'm gonna see him again tonight. And we're gonna drink it in Long Beach in a parking lot if we have to, so that he can try this. This is insane, and it is spicy. It is really spicy. Wow. Sweet sassy molassy, guys. Wow. It's a toasted nuttiness. The spices of the curry. It is so on point with curry food. It is like they took like a bunch of buffet curry food and just pressed it and strained it, and it's alcohol, and it's actually good. Wow. That is so surprising. I'm possibly gonna put Leia on video when she takes a sip of it. It's kind of gassy. Takes a sip of this. She has to try this. Woo! I'm like Ric Flair. Woo! So where are we going? We're going to Steel Press?
Steel Craft. It is a shipping container food court.
Shipping container food court. So an even more hipster chic than the Anaheim Packing District.
Oh yes, oh yes.
So hipster chic.
They didn't even repurpose that building. They repurposed shipping containers.
Yeah, that's like reclaimed wood times 1,000, right?
The only way you're getting more hipster than that is if you build the building from unrecyclable bottles.
Those are all steel bins that they've repurposed. Saying Kauai or Hawaii.
Kauai.
Okay. I'm with a K, right? I'm just making sure I get it. Okay.
This is their secret menu.
Oh, what?
Is it taro?
Cold brew. Which they brew
cold brew coffee?
Kona coffee. They brew their own Kona coffee, citing brew, Ghirardelli chocolate, organic Oreo crumbles, and coconut
Oreo flavored Oreos.
The first.
Oh my goodness.
And the mustaches are
chocolate on the top.
I'm excited about the coffee. Cold brew coffee shaved ice. What? Cold brew coffee shaved ice. That's what that is, right? Cold brew?
Yeah, it's cold brew.
Don't get that to Ben. Ben, you can't have the cold brew coffee. You crazy? You crazy? Ben, you crazy. You crazy. Hold on, we'll get you some of the other one.
Nutella. Fluffy on the inside, slightly sweet.
A little girl yelled at her mom repeatedly until she looked
at her. You don't love me if you don't buy this.
And that little girl was our...
The piano crosswalk. Check that out. Pretty cool. This is a Fiat convertible, a little spider. That's pretty cool. It's an ABARF. Is it a rear-wheel drive? I want to see if it's rear-wheel drive. It is. It's rear-wheel drive. That's pretty freaking cool. What's the front end look like? I like that. All right, I'm out of here.
Like, am I getting fans doing this? Like, they just see it as just another
So there's a comment that I get a lot is that, like, I just fix stuff. I'm just fixing random stuff all the time. I've got a broken chair arm here. I'm gonna fix it really quick. My dad's gonna be in town tomorrow. Guys, if your father's still with us, you know there's one thing you never want, and then you never want to see your dad see something that's broken in your own home. So we're gonna fix that right now so he doesn't have to see that, and I don't feel bad. Or my wife doesn't give me crap about it. What, Ben? Why are you laughing at me? Don't laugh at me, Ben. Don't laugh at me. You don't laugh at me. You don't laugh at me, son. What did he do to my glue? Don't laugh at your leg. To get all the residue up, you're gonna have to get like a moist towel. Beer in a steel container? How can one have such things? It's like the evolution of the food truck, right? It's a, how do we serve beer? Well, we can't serve beer out of a truck, so how do we serve beer? We gotta have a physical location to serve beer. What's the best place, cheapest way to do that? Out of a metal shipping container. Can't argue with that logic. Question of the day. Food truck or pop-up store or even a swap meet. I know swap meets serve beer. Like, what is your favorite street food? It could be local street food, it could be foreign, if you've been to another country. What's your favorite street food, Ben?
Waffle.
What?
Waffle.
Oh, waffle. Yeah, waffle. Favorite street food is waffle. Sure. Yeah, that's good. It's a good pick, bud. So, I like street food that you can have a beer when you're chilling on the street. Why not? That curry beer, oh my god, that is crazy. Anyway guys, that'll do it for today. Post your comments below, love to hear your opinions. As always, if you have not already, please give me a thumbs up. Loved if you would subscribe, and we will talk to you tomorrow.